So this is the normal anatomical bone model.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a 3D printed model.
Okay.
So in this case, what we have found out that the tibia is externally rotated,
mm-hmm.
and the femur is internally bent.
Okay.
So that is why this is the patella.
Yeah.
It has come to this side.
Yeah.
Right. I cannot show you otherwise.
Yeah, you break it. Yeah.
So what we are going to do is the CT scan images that we have taken.
Yeah.
It is a very complex case. Actually, mm-hmm. to be very honest.
Okay.
In humans, whenever such complex cases are there, what they used to do is they take CT scan images and they do a 3D printing just like this.
Yeah.
So we are going to do a 3D print for that, so that we can actually plan for the surgery. And just now we were having a discussion like what procedures we are going to do in this one. So let's say tibia is like this.
Yeah.
So we are going to do a proximal tibial osteotomy.
You will have to see that.
Proximal tibial osteotomy.
What does that mean?
So that is like to align this. Tibia, this is the proximal part of tibia.
Yeah.
This is the distal part.
Okay.
So we will be cutting through it and aligning it in this in a normal direction so that it comes in the straight way. And we will be also doing a distal femoral osteotomy.
Okay.
We might have to do, I will not say that we will, because once the 3D printed implant comes, then we will be deciding that. So we will be cutting a little bit of this and aligning that also. And plus, we will be also putting an implant that is called as patellar groove replacement.
Yeah, PGR.
So, yeah, PGR. So this is the patellar groove, here you can see.
Yeah.
So actually implant is there. It has been recently introduced in India, but like when I was in other countries, Dr. Kunal was in other countries, so we used to do it on regular basis. So we will source the implant. And the implant will be here so that the patella can actually glide over it.
Okay.
Actually, why it has happened, let me explain you that also.
Yes.
Yeah. So actually what happens is, like, let's say this is the normal genetics. Due to some defect or due to something, the femur get internally bent. So if the femur get internally bent, the patella shift ends.
Yeah.
And the groove that we are seeing here is actually not a genetic thing.
Okay.
Actually, it forms when the patella slides over it, like this. So it is, you can see the patella gliding over. So this forms the groove because of the pressure.
Okay.
And since the child was, because the groove is not there, the patella is not there, the groove is not formed. So that is why we have to do the implant.
Got it.
Right.
It's a natural groove that comes with the movement.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.